What is research? Research starts with some fundamental questions. We want to know relations between a few variables. So there are a few variables. We want to know their relationship. What kind of relationship exists? This relationship can be identified through the process of research. The variables can have various types of relationships. Therefore, we have brought in two types of researches. One is based on quantitative research, and the other is, instead of quantitative, we have qualitative research. The name denotes quantitative means we are using numbers. Quantity. We have to undertake strong statistical analysis, find out relations between the variables using quantitative research methods. Therefore, the sample size has to be very large so that statistically we can prove that whatever research we have carried out among the variables is right. For example, if we are talking about two variables, let's say there is a variable of price, demand. And we say when price rises, demand falls. Now this research can very well be classified as quantitative research. And we can carry out this research using numbers, statistics. What do we do? We undertake statistical analysis. So through statistics we can prove that whenever price rises, demand falls, or reverse, whenever price falls, demand rises. Now for this, we will require very large number of data, which we can analyze statistically. So when we have huge numbers available, when we can take a large database, undertake statistical analysis, quantitative research is possible. And therefore, the research design of quantitative research will use very large numbers, right? It must be very large, minimum, I am just writing it minimum. Minimum must be 30, but ideally it should be very large. How much? That depends upon our statistical requirement. Like we want very high level of accuracy, very high level of accuracy, then we will require very high numbers so that we can prove that in almost every case, whenever price rises, demand falls. But if we have taken up a very small sample, then we cannot statistically prove it because our sample size itself is very small. But this is only in case of quantitative research. Qualitative research is different. That will focus on qualitative relationship between certain variables. That may not be proved using numbers, but that will be proved on the basis of the quality of relationship, quality of variables. For example, what is happening in the mind of a leader? How is leader thinking? What is the decision making style of an entrepreneur? What kind of problems is faced by a woman entrepreneur? Right? These are some of the researches which can be carried out in quantitative as well as qualitative, both. For example, what is the thinking of women entrepreneurs about the problems that they are facing from the society? Now, you can go for this kind of research in qualitative research also. But when there are some researches where the sample size is very low, very small. For example, you want to know what is happening now in the minds of freedom fighters of India. What is their thinking about India's current status, current development? Now, freedom fighters, very few freedom fighters are alive now because most of them are not alive now. The sample cannot be large. It won't be even minimum 30 numbers. Very small sample size is there. So when very few persons are available now, instead of going for quantitative research, we would like to go for qualitative research. So in case of qualitative research, the sample size is small, but we will go deep into the research. We will prove ask questions, lot of questions, ask again and again questions to know what is happening in the mind of the person or what is the thinking or whatever the situation, whatever we want to study. So in the entire research, we must say the first thing is, what is our research objective? So research objectives have to be very well defined. Based on the research objective, our further research will take place, whether it is quantitative research or qualitative research. Now your question is, how do we get research objectives? Because this is the fundamental, this is the foundation for our entire research. But to start with the research objective, we must first look at previous researches. If we have taken up any study for research, first of all identify, has anybody carried out a research on this topic? If nobody has carried out research on this topic, then it is called exploratory research. And then we are doing it for the first time. So the basic purpose is to know fundamental relationship. And in case of exploratory research, qualitative research is considered to be generally most preferred research. Because we don't know the relationship, we have to identify the variables. What are the variables? But if people have already carried out research and we want to know more detail, for example, leadership. Lot of researches have been carried out on leadership. For example, entrepreneurship. Lot of researches have been carried out on entrepreneurship. Now we want to study some more important things. We want to study it in detail. We want to identify a particular relationship. Then we will go for analytical research. We will go for quantitative research. So what do we do? The first step is literature review. I would not say it's the first step, but it is, you can say second step. The first step is deciding where you want to carry out research, which field you want to take up, what will the benefit of your research to the society. Society must benefit from your research. That is the first step. Once you decide that this is the field, like you want to study with leadership, what you will do? You will carry out literature review. You will study at least 30, 40, 50 articles relating to literature, relating to that subject, previous researches. And in that, you will study particularly. If you are taking up 50 articles, for each of them, you will identify what was their objective, what was their methodology, what was the finding, and what are their suggestion for future. Most of the researchers also write that in future, this kind of research should be carried out, because they say that we could not do it, you should do it. So when you read these, you will find there are plenty of issues on which research has not been carried out. That is called gap, identification of gap or gap analysis. Then there is a gap in research. Lot of research has to be carried in that particular field. Because people have not done that, people have suggested us to do that study. For example, entrepreneurship. Plenty of researches have been carried out on entrepreneurship. But most of the researchers have said they have not studied the women entrepreneurs who are doing entrepreneurship in desert areas of Rajasthan through self-help groups and other means. They are very poor, they are from very poor families, still they are struggling to start their own business organizations. Now most of the entrepreneurship studies have not focused on them. This is a gap. Now, what is their situation? In which situation they start? What problems do they face? How do they overcome that problem? All these things have to be studied through gap. You identify, nobody has carried out a research, therefore you have to carry out a research. Then you have to prepare your entire research design, your steps, how will you carry out. In research design also, you have to decide about sample size. Because we cannot study universe. Universe study means studying everybody. Suppose you are studying women entrepreneurs of Rajasthan. So you are studying every woman entrepreneur. Then it is called census. But census is generally not possible because it's very large. And we don't have that much of time to study and meet everybody. In some cases it may be possible. For example, you are carrying out a study of Bharat Ratna people. What is their contribution to the country? What is their feeling? How do they feel? The sample size is small because the number of people are very small. There is no need of sample. You can go for universe. You can meet everybody. But when it is not possible to meet everybody, then you have to go for sample. sample is a small number out of the universe, which represents the characteristics of the entire universe. So sampling should be done very carefully. There are many methods to do sampling. But always remember, for a good research, the best method is always one, which is random sampling. Sometimes you can do purposive sampling also, judgment sampling also. Sometimes, especially in qualitative research. Judgment sample. But most appropriate in quantitative as well as in qualitative research, the most appropriate research is random sampling. Means randomly picking up through lottery. There are 1000 people, out of that you are taking only 100. So randomly, through lottery, picking up 100 people. That is called random sampling. Judgment sampling is picking up people who meet your requirement, who meet your criteria. So you pick up only those people who fulfill your requirement. That number is very small and thereby you are ensuring a small sample. That is called judgment sampling. It is appropriate in case of qualitative research where you are doing a small particular study on a number of people. There are some other type of samplings. For example, convenience sampling. We don't suggest that because that's not considered to be very good method of research. There are other methods like snowball sampling, quota sampling, etc. So quota sampling is picking up or random sampling, stratified random sampling. Stratified random sampling and quota sampling will help you in picking up a few persons from a particular category. Like in stratified random sampling, you will just divide the entire universe into different strata and then pick up 10% people from each strata, something like that. So that is one possible sampling. So you can further decide what kind of sampling you want to do. So you have to plan out, use appropriate method of sampling, and after the sampling has been done, you will have to decide how to carry out the study. So you will carry out a pilot study. Pilot study is like trial. Once you find this is appropriate, like your research instruments, what is research instrument? Research instruments are like questionnaire or other instruments to which you collect data.
Okay.
Right? You will identify, you will carry out, prepare, test. Once they are ready, you find data collected proper. You will put that in statistical analysis. Use SPSS, they are printed softwares. SPSS is one of them. I am not advocating SPSS, you can use many other statistical softwares that you can use to find out relationship between variables on a statistical analysis basis. Now at this point, you have to decide about your level of statistical significance. At what level you would like the relations to be appropriate. Like for example, you want 95% accuracy. So, up to 5% errors are permitted. So that you have to decide. So you will decide, undertake statistical analysis, find out which statistical tools you can use. There are hundreds of thousands of statistical tools. You have to decide. For example, if you just want relation between two variables, right? You can very use very simple tools like correlation, regression, right? These are very simple statistical tools. They can tell you what is the relation between two variables. Right? But then many lines, we don't have two variables, we have many multiple variables. Right? In fact, we have to reduce these variables during the process of research to find out which two variables or three variables or four variables are most important. So accordingly, you have to use appropriate statistical tools to undertake data analysis. And then see the statistical accuracy. Analyze the data, present them in graphical format, and prepare your report. And in report, you have to submit all these along with your statistical level of significance. In the research, when we undertake statistical analysis and prove relation between two variables, then we are basically testing relations between two variables, which we have started during the research. So therefore, in case of quantitative research, statistical analysis, we have one more word which is very important, that is called a hypothesis. Hypothesis is relationship between variables that we assume, that we think is there based on our previous literature. So we have relationship between two variables. We go with that assumption that this is the relationship, either it is there or not there. So we prove that hypothesis in a statistical analysis. Either the hypothesis is proved or disapproved. Therefore, there are two hypotheses. The one is null hypothesis, one is alternate hypothesis. We check these hypotheses through statistical analysis. And whatever finding we are able to find, we will submit them in